When you're transitioning over to Linux, it can be intimidating to use Linux simply because you don't know what software or programs you can use with Linux that may be compatible with or equivalent to the programs you've been using on Macintosh or Linux, or on Windows, rather. So, with that in mind, there are some programs you should consider using that are very compatible and almost equal to the programs you may be currently using on Macintosh or Windows that are open source and are free to use. And one of the first programs I'm going to show you probably are already using right now in a different form is Mozilla Firefox. Mozilla Firefox is available on Linux, and you can safely use it on it's available on Linux, Macintosh, and Windows, and you can safely use it on Linux. It's pretty much identical to what you've already been using, so there should be no difficulty in you transitioning over to this version of a browser. And it's probably going to be one of the things you're going to use the most when you're actually using Linux. Another thing to consider is what type of Microsoft Office or Office programs you're going to be using that are compatible with Microsoft Office. What Linux Office software is there that's compatible with Microsoft Office? And that is LibreOffice. Now, it does have a writer document, a calculating spreadsheet, which is like Excel, Impress presentation, which is like PowerPoint, and base database, which is like Access, and draw is like Microsoft Paint. I'll show you a different alternative to using draw in LibreOffice that you may find to be a little bit more powerful. And if you're at all familiar with Linux, you're probably already going to guess what exactly I'm going to show you. So with LibreOffice, it comes with many of the Linux distros. In fact, actually, you are given the option to install it automatically when you are actually going through the installation process of installing Linux, either on one of your older machines or one of your current machines, or if you're dual booting or using a virtual machine. Regardless, you're probably going to be given the option, or it's going to be already installed. So it should be no difficulty for you to use it. Another program to consider is a VLC media player. VLC media player plays a whole variety of basically media, saved video files. If you should create a video file, you want to see it in VLC media player. It will play DVDs, it will play Blu-ray, it will play CDs, etc. So you can use this VLC media player for a wide variety of media. In fact, actually, you can also use it for online media sources in many cases. So if there's an online media stream that you want to attach to, you can use it with the VLC media player, and it will attach to that stream and then stream it for you. Of course, it has to be, number one, compatible with it, and you should be able to know how to do that. So this comes free. You can install it. It's really easy to install. Just refer back to the installation instructions earlier in this course on how to install it, and you should be fine. Okay, so I mentioned a more powerful image editing program. And the image editing program that I was talking about was called GIMP, or The GIMP. The GIMP is very similar to Adobe Photoshop. It's almost as powerful. It could be, depending upon how you use it, as powerful as Adobe Photoshop, except it's actually free. So that saves you a monthly fee to Adobe if you should be using Adobe Photoshop. And saving you money is all what I'm about. So you can use this to create files that you can use later on. You can open up your files from your camera. Say, for instance, if you should be doing landscape photography or any other type of photography, this can open up a wide range of possibilities for you to use. It's extremely powerful. I recommend that you look for separate tutorials on how to use it. I'm not going to cover it in depth in this particular course, but there are tutorials on how to use it that you can find either on this platform or other platforms. So keep that in mind. Okay, another program to consider is Caden Live. Caden Live is very similar to all of the video editing software. There's so many of them available. I don't want to compare it to one or another. You know, I don't want to necessarily offend anyone who's watching this video of what your favorite video editing software may be, but Caden Live is a great way for you to edit videos on your Linux machine so that you can basically export them out to other sources, whether it be YouTube or Instagram or, you know, wherever you want to put. If there's like some homework you have to do where you have to create videos, this is a great way for you to create videos for free using software that you would normally have to pay an enormous amount of money for, but you don't have to because you have a free open source version of a video editing software that you can use to create high quality videos. Obviously, you want to be concerned more about the content of your videos than the actual process of editing, but you know, there's tutorials on how to use this. So you may want to look up the tutorials on how to use this particular piece of software so that you can get the most power out of it. This will not be covered in this course because that would be out of the scope of the course, but I just wanted to point out to you that this software does exist. Okay. So that should give you some idea of the various software programs you should consider when you're transitioning to Linux. Okay, you can transition to Linux over a period of time. It will take some time for you to do it. You may have to use both your Windows machine or your Mac machine along with your Linux machine instead of going cold turkey. Some people choose to go cold turkey with it. And yeah, you can, but in order to do that, you kind of need to know what the programs are on your Linux machine and how to use them before you do that. Otherwise, you're really going to slow your productivity. So transitioning over involves not only learning Linux, but also learning the software programs that are on Linux that are part of your daily workflow. So transitioning over with that, you would want to basically practice how to do your workflow on those particular pieces of software so that you can actually become proficient enough so it doesn't stop your workflow. Now, anyway, I hope you found this video to be helpful.